Assalamualaikum everyone, I hope you are all doing amazing. If you are new to the channel, hi, my name is Jawad. I am a first year medical student studying at King Edward Medical University. Today I am going to revise the joints of the lower limb. Basically this is a revision video. If you have studied before, you are gonna have a good time revising all of the ligaments of the lower limb. If it is your first time, don't worry, you are gonna get something out of this. So without further ado, let's start with the video. First of all, we are going to discuss the joint capsules of all of the joints of the major joints of the lower limb. First of all, we have the hip joint. The hip joint capsule is thick and firmly attached anterior superiorly, and posterior inferiorly it is thin and loosely attached. As you can see in this video, in front it is thick and firmly attached. It is attached to the intertrochanteric line of the femur below and to the margins of the acetabulum, and extends beyond the margin of the acetabulum above. Above it is attached to the margin of the acetabulum, and below it is attached to the intertrochanteric line in front and 1 centimeter behind the intertrochanteric crest posteriorly. Posteriorly ye intertrochanteric crest yahan par hoti hai, theek hai? So it is attached 1 centimeter behind the intertrochanteric crest. So this is basically the attachment of the capsule of the hip joint, and it is very very strong anterior superiorly, and posterior inferiorly it is weak and deficient. Let me show you. Here it is weak and deficient anterior posteriorly. Posteriorly it is weak and deficient. So let's get back to what we were saying. Now I'm going to talk about the acetabular labrum. Basically the acetabular labrum is a fibrocartilaginous disc covering the acetabulum, and its purpose is to deepen the socket for the hip joint. Basically the purpose of the acetabular labrum, this fibrocartilaginous disc that is attached to the margins of the acetabulum, that is attached all around the margins of the acetabulum except the acetabular notch, the purpose of this acetabular labrum is to deepen the socket for the hip joint. Next we have got, here you can also see the acetabular labrum. Here it is a fibrocartilaginous disc attached to the margins of the acetabulum. Next we have got the knee joint, the capsule of the knee joint. The capsule of the knee joint is deficient anteriorly and both sides, anteriorly on both sides, on the femur it is deficient anterior superiorly, deficient anterior superiorly, and is attached to the sides below, and on the tibia it is deficient at the position of the tibial tuberosity, and it is firmly attached onto the sides. So basically the knee joint, capsule of the knee joint is deficient anteriorly. Posteriorly the capsule of the knee joint is attached onto the intercondylar line of the femur and the intercondylar ridge of the tibia. Here you can see the attachment of the capsule of the knee joint. It is deficient on this area and it is firmly attached on the sides and below, and on the back side, on posteriorly, it is attached onto the intercondylar line and the intercondylar ridge. So next we have the capsule of the ankle joint. The ankle joint's capsule is also weak anteriorly and posteriorly, and it is weak anteriorly and posteriorly, and it is strong on the sides due to the presence of collateral ligaments. So it covers the whole of the ankle joint, which includes the lower ends of the tibia and fibula, the talus completely, and some parts of the calcaneum and navicular. Then we have the ligaments of hip and femur. These include, first of all, the inguinal ligament. The inguinal ligament is attached from the anterior superior iliac spine laterally, and medially it is attached to the pubic tubercle. Medially it is attached to the pubic tubercle, laterally it is attached to the anterior superior iliac spine. This, my friends, here is the inguinal ligament. Then we have got the sacrotuberous and the sacrospinous ligaments. These are the ligaments, as the name suggests, sacrotuberous, from sacrum to the tuberosity. Tuberosity which? Ischial tuberosity. And sacrospinous, as the name suggests, from the sacrum to the ischial spine. Here you can see, from the sacrum to the ischial tuberosity and from the sacrum to the ischial spine. These are the two ligaments. The purpose of these ligaments is to convert the greater and lesser sciatic notches into foramina. The purpose of these ligaments is to convert the greater and lesser sciatic notches into foramina. Then we move on here. In this diagram, you can clearly see the sacrospinous ligament and the sacrotuberous ligament. Next, we move on to the lacunar ligament and the pectineal ligament of Cooper. The lacunar ligament is basically a ligament that is attached from the inguinal ligament to the pectineal line on the pubis, on the body of the pubis, the pectineal line on the body of the pubis. This ligament has a significance in hernia because during femoral hernia, the surgeon ligates this ligament to widen the femoral canal to allow the abdominal contents to pass through. Therefore, it is important in hernial surgery. And then we have a small ligament called pectineal ligament of Cooper. Here, let me show you. The ligament, this one, this ligament attached along the length of this pectineal line is called the pectineal ligament of Cooper. It is attached just below the attachment of the lacunar ligament. It is attached just below the attachment of the lacunar ligament. Then we have got the obturator membrane. The obturator membrane aligns the obturator foramen except for the obturator canal. Obturator canal from which the obturator nerves and vessels are transmitted. It is a membrane that firmly attaches and bridges the obturator foramen. So this is the obturator membrane. Then we move on to the pubic symphysis, which is a fibrous disc, which is a fibrocartilaginous disc, as you guys can see here. As you guys can see in this diagram, this is a fibrocartilaginous disc between the two pubic bones, This is the pubic symphysis. Then we have got the iliofemoral, pubofemoral, and ischiofemoral ligaments. These are basically the ligaments that strengthen the hip joint. The iliofemoral ligament is also known as the inverted Y-shaped ligament of Bigelow. Its apex is attached to the anterior inferior iliac spine and its base is attached to the intertrochanteric line. Apex, anterior inferior iliac spine, base to the intertrochanteric line. Then we have the pubofemoral ligament. Pubofemoral ligament is attached onto the iliopubic eminence, onto the this iliopubic eminence, and inferiorly it blends with this iliofemoral ligament. This ligament blends with this iliofemoral ligament. Then we have got the ischiofemoral ligament or the posterior ligament. It is attached onto the hip joint from ischium to the acetabulum, and onto the femur it is attached to the greater trochanter. So this ligament extends from the greater trochanter to the ischium and the acetabulum. This is a comparatively weak ligament as compared to the ligaments in front, anterior ligaments, two ligaments, which were the iliofemoral and pubofemoral ligaments. It is a comparatively weak ligament. So next we move on to the ligamentum teres, which is also called the ligament of head of the femur, and the transverse acetabular ligament. Ligamentum teres is basically a ligament that is attached onto the fovea capitis and to the transverse acetabular ligament onto the hip. Basically, the purpose of this ligament is to keep or hold the head of the femur in place. Then we have the transverse acetabular ligament, which is attached to the ends of this lunate shaped surface of the acetabulum, area of the acetabulum, and bridges the acetabular notch. It basically bridges the acetabular notch and allows for the acetabular vessels and nerves to pass through. Then we have got the ligaments of the knee. First of all, we have got the ligamentum patelli, which is the ligament attached from the patella to the tibial tuberosity. Tibial tuberosity se leke patella tak ek ligament laga hota hai, which is called the ligamentum patelli. Basically, it is an expansion or extension of the tendon of the quadriceps femoris because patella is a sesamoid bone in the tendon of the quadriceps femoris. Then we have got the tibial and fibular collateral ligaments. These are the ligaments that are present on the sides of the knee joint and strengthen the knee joint. Here in this diagram, you can see the tibial collateral ligament, which is attached onto the medial condyle of the femur, and below it is attached just below the medial condyle of the tibia. And we have the fibular collateral ligament, which is attached to the lateral condyle of the femur, and below it is attached to the styloid process on the head of the fibula. These are the two collateral ligaments as seen from behind, posterior view. Then we have got the oblique and arcuate popliteal ligaments. The oblique popliteal ligament is basically a projection of the tendon of the semimembranosus. This is the semimembranosus tendon, and the oblique popliteal ligament is basically a projection of this semimembranosus tendon. Oblique popliteal ligament is basically a projection of this semimembranosus tendon. And the arcuate popliteal ligament is a ligament that is attached from the head of the fibula to the intercondylar area. From the head of the fibula to the intercondylar area of the tibia. So these are basically the two popliteal ligaments. Then we have got the anterior and posterior cruciate ligaments. These are very thick and strong ligaments that are the main bonds of union. That are the main bonds of union between the tibia and fibula. Main bonds of union between the tibia and fibula, as you guys can see. The anterior cruciate ligament is attached onto the anterior part of the intercondylar area of the tibia, and the posterior cruciate ligament is attached to the posterior part of the intercondylar area of the tibia. In this diagram, you can clearly see this is the anterior cruciate ligament and this is the posterior cruciate ligament. And this is basically the oblique or lateral ligament. Here, in this diagram, you can clearly see the attachment points. This is for the anterior cruciate ligament on the anterior end of the intercondylar area, and this is for the posterior cruciate ligament on the posterior part of the intercondylar area, and these are the horns of the two menisci. This is the lateral meniscus and this is the medial meniscus. Horns, attachment for the horns of the two menisci. Then we have got the medial and lateral menisci. These are basically fibrocartilaginous discs. These are basically fibrocartilaginous discs that are present between the two condyles of the tibia and fibula, tibia and femur, and they basically deepen the socket. And provide cushioning pads for the resting of the femur onto the tibia. Here you can clearly see the medial meniscus and the lateral meniscus. These are fibrocartilaginous discs. The medial meniscus is almost semicircular. Here you can see the medial meniscus is almost semicircular and the lateral meniscus is almost a circle, almost a circle. Here you can clearly see the discs or pads. Then we have a transverse ligament. This ligament bridges the anterior end of the two menisci. This basically transverse ligament connects the anterior parts of the two menisci. This transverse ligament basically connects the anterior parts of the two menisci. So here you can clearly see this transverse ligament. Then we have got the ligaments of tibia and fibula. We have the superior tibiofibular joint. The ligaments included are the anterior and posterior. Basically these are anterosuperior and posterosuperior ligaments of the superior tibiofibular joint. Here you can clearly see the posterior superior tibiofibular ligament. Similar ligament would be present on the anterior side. In this diagram, which you cannot clearly see, yes, you can clearly see. This is the anterior proximal tibiofibular ligament and this, my friends, is the posterior superior or proximal tibiofibular ligament. Then we have got the middle ligament, which is also called the introitious membrane. Introitious membrane is basically a fibrous joint, a fibrous connection between the tibia and fibula. Its purpose is weight transmission between the tibia and fibula, and it also provides attachment to certain muscles. Here we can see the introitious membrane between the introitious, let me make it clear, between the introitious or medial border of the fibula and introitious or medial border or lateral border, introitious or lateral border of the tibia and introitious or medial border of the fibula. This membrane is present between these structures. So it binds the tibia and fibula together. Then we have got the anterior, posterior and introitious ligaments of the inferior tibiofibular joint. The inferior tibiofibular joint is basically a syndesmosis because it contains three ligaments, compound ligaments. Basically a syndesmosis is a joint that is bound by a membrane and two collateral ligaments are present on both sides. So this, my friends, is the introitious ligament of the inferior tibiofibular joint. This is the anterior inferior tibiofibular ligament. And this is the anterior inferior posterior inferior tibiofibular ligament. Introitious, anterior, and posterior. Then we have got the ligaments of ankle and foot. This is basically the deltoid ligament. It is a medial ligament. It is a very, very strong ligament. Therefore, the medial ankle sprains are very less common. Basically, lateral ankle sprains are more common. It consists of four ligaments in two parts. The first three are superficial and the last is a deep part. Let me show you through the diagram. This, my friends, is the tibio-calcaneal ligament. This is the tibio-navicular ligament. This is the posterior tibio-talar ligament. Tibio-talar, tibio-calcaneal, tibio-navicular. There are two tibio-talar ligaments. One is superficial, one is deep. One is posterior, one is anterior. So this you can remember, two tibio-talar ligaments, one tibio-calcaneal and one tibio-navicular ligament. Then we have got the lateral ligament. It consists of three bands. All of them are superficial. And these are two talofibular ligaments, which are the anterior and posterior talofibular ligament, and one calcaneofibular ligament. Here, let me show you. This ligament between the fibula and the calcaneum is the calcaneofibular ligament. The one on the posterior side attaching to the talus, from fibula to the talus, is the posterior talofibular ligament, and the one attaching from the fibula to the talus anteriorly is the anterior talofibular ligament. This anterior talofibular ligament is the most commonly dislocated ligament. This is the most commonly dislocated ligament or torn ligament. Therefore, lateral ankle sprains are basically due to the spraining or tearing of this anterior talofibular ligament. This is its clinical significance. Ligaments of the talocalcaneonavicular joint. The talocalcaneonavicular joint is a compound variety of joint because it is formed between three bones, the talus, the calcaneum and the navicular. This ligament, these are basically the spring ligament and the medial limb of the bifurcate ligament. The spring ligament is basically a very strong ligament. It is present medially and it is ideal for maintaining and important for maintaining of medial longitudinal arch of the foot. This is basically the spring ligament between the calcaneum and the cuboid, between the calcaneum and the navicular bone, between calcaneum and the navicular bone. This is the talocalcaneonavicular joint and it is between the calcaneum and the navicular bone. Then we have got the medial limb of the bifurcate ligament. Bifurcate ligament is basically attaching from the calcaneum to the cuboid, navicular and talus. Talus through the introcious ligament. It is attaching to the talus through the introcious ligament, to the navicular through the medial limb, and the lateral limb is attaching to the cuboid, which we will discuss shortly. Then we have got the ligaments of the calcaneocuboid joint. Calcaneocuboid joint, the bifurcate ligament, lateral limb of the bifurcate ligament, which we just discussed. Medial limb is attaching to the navicular, lateral limb is attaching to the cuboid from the calcaneum and to the talus through the introcious ligament. Therefore, we have got this lateral limb of bifurcate ligament. Then we have got the long plantar and short plantar ligaments. These are also the ligaments of the calcaneocuboid joint. Here you can clearly see the short plantar ligament and the long plantar ligament. These are the two ligaments that are very important in maintaining the arches of the foot. This spring ligament for the medial longitudinal arch and these long plantar ligament also for the medial longitudinal arch and partially for the lateral longitudinal arch. For both arches of the foot, mainly for the medial longitudinal arch. Then we have got the ligaments of the metatarsophalangeal and interphalangeal joint. We have got the metatarsophalangeal joint ligament, which are basically the articular capsule. There are some collateral ligaments and then there is the deep transverse metatarsal ligament. Let me show you. These are the deep transverse metatarsal ligaments. In hand, we discuss the deep transverse metacarpal ligaments. In foot, we are discussing the deep transverse metatarsal ligament. And as you can see, this is the metatarsophalangeal joint. There are collateral ligaments. There is a joint capsule. There is this joint capsule. And there are also some plantar ligaments. You can clearly see here. Let me erase it. Yes, you can clearly see this is the plantar ligament. the plantar ligament, and there are collateral ligaments. These are the collateral ligaments, and there is a joint capsule. So this was it for today, all of the ligaments of lower limb in one place. I hope you have got all of the concepts or some of them, and I do hope you like this video. So this is the end, and hope to see you in the next video. Like, subscribe, share, and I have left anything or I have oversaid anything or if I have said something wrong, do let me know in the comments below, and I am going to address that issue. Thank you for tuning in. Allah Hafiz.